Welcome to Genesis Engineers Academy. In this video, I am going to discuss on problems solving on properties of steam. Before going into the details, so I will explain the graph, that is temperature and enthalpy graph. This is a temperature, that is on y-axis, and it is in Celsius. And this is enthalpy, that is energy per unit. Here I have taken zero at which the water is available, because the steam tables are made treating or assuming the water supply at 0 degrees Celsius. That is why I have taken this is 0 degrees is my starting point at which water is available, and after that, so there are some points. One is called F, that is called saturated water or liquid, and this is G, that is saturated, that is dry saturated. In between, it is wet steam. It is wet steam, means water plus steam. So this quality is denoted by X. So at F, X is equal to 0. At G, X is equal to 1. You got my point? So the water is being supplied, the heat, that is as shown here, heating. And by adding heat, its state changes, that is temperature changes. At this F point, this we call it as saturation temperature. So that is also called as boiling point. So this saturation temperature is particularly related to a particular pressure. So this saturation pressure is not fixed for all. So it depends upon the pressure at which it is being heated. Okay. So two words, one is called F, the other one is called G. So this is 0 point, and we are heating to this point, and at this F point we can assume that the water reaches saturation point. That means it is about to vaporize. It is about to vaporize, and then further heating will change the quality of the steam. That here it at G, this becomes dry saturated, means water part is fully removed, but there will be traces of steam, and then that is called water, and that also can be removed by superheating. So this green color graph, that is curve, is very important. The left part is liquid, and this is called liquid plus vapor, and this is vapor, this is superheated vapor. You have to understand clearly. So at that point, boiling point is reached, that is bubbles are formed, and it is about to vaporize. So our problems will be about the situation. You have to identify whether the steam is wet or dry or superheated, or in some cases whether it has been reached the saturation or not. So for that they will mention pressure and temperature. Based on these two properties, you have to fix the, at least fix the, that is the quality of the steam. Here X is equal to 0 means that is steam part is 0. Okay, that is why. And this is X part is X is equal to 1, fully steam, that is called dry saturated. So in between you can assume that it may be 0.5. Okay, so this is X. That means you have to find out what is the enthalpy at this stage. So enthalpy at x will be generally, so this property is reached from this place. So steam tables are provided giving these values only, not this. If this has to be reached, you have to use the general formula, that is equal to specific heat into temperature difference. You got my point. So what is the enthalpy at this point? So at this point it is Hg. At this point it is Hf. So you can draw vertical line here. You can draw vertical line like this one, if graph is given. So in the table they will directly give you that is F. So this is Hf, this is Hg, and the difference between this and this we call it as Hg minus Hf. That can be represented like HgF, and the sometimes that can be represented as L. That means it is a latent heat. You got my point. So Hx is equal to Hf, that is the starting point, into quality into Hg minus Hf. Okay, so that is that. So after it has been reached G point, if we further heat, so that steam quality will be same, but that stresses also will be removed, and that steam is used for running of the turbine. That prevents the, that is called rusting or damage of the turbine blades. Okay, so this point I can call it as a critical point. So at this point, so it won't changes, what is that, water to fully water to saturated water, and then wet steam, and then dry steam, and then superheated steam. This is the changes the water will get by supplying the heat or by absorbing the heat. Okay, so this is, and this evaporation is always taking place at constant temperature, that is saturation temperature. Okay, so this F and G, from F to G, the process has been taking place at constant temperature. Okay, so now if I heated the water further, and this point is S. Okay, so see these points. Okay, so that is the point of that. Okay, so what you have to understand, so if you understand this graph clearly, you can solve any type of problem. And next, the temperature difference between this, so saturation to superheated, this part sometimes called as degree of superheat. You got my point? So that is very important. So one thing is H0, they will give treating water at 0 degree centigrade. If water is supplied suppose at 25 degree centigrade, so you have to deduct from the value you used from the got this from the steam tables. Okay, so suppose if anything is given, HF is given, so HF is treating water at 0 degrees in. So what is the heat required to reach this saturation point? So you get it some value, suppose 100, and you have to deduct this amount, that is minus C into, that is 25 minus 0. So this amount has to be deducted or subtracted from the value HF. Okay, so that is very important. So students usually make mistake at this point. And one more thing is, you have to always concentrate on units. Okay, next one, I'll move on to, that is the next slide, that is the first problem. So determine the dryness fraction of steam if 0.8 kg of water, so I can call it as water, that is MF, so this is MF. That is before saturated, and it is in suspension with 45 kg of dry steam. That is, it is mg. So, dry g, that is saturated, is F. So, the total, that is, if water is there in steam, that steam we call it as a wet steam. Okay. So, that I can call it as mx. So, I use the notation g for dry saturated and F for saturated and x, that is wet. That is wet steam and dry, and this is saturated, simply saturated. This is dry saturated. Okay. So, what is that dryness fraction? Mass of actual dry, that is g. Next, mg plus mf. This I called as mx. So, by putting all these things, so I got this value 0.982. So, that means this value shows that it has reaching the, so it is reaching the, that is dry saturated. Okay. So, next problem, that what is the condition of the steam? If the pressure is 10 bar and enthalpy is 2700 kilojoules per kg. Okay. So, from steam tables, you have to get the enthalpy at HF and HG. Okay. So, from the steam table, I got this value, that is HF is equal to, see this one. So, HF is equal to, that is 762.61, and this is HG. So, this is HG, this is HF. Okay. So, the same values I have used here. Okay. So, the enthalpy at that point, that means if the graph is there, so this is G. Okay. So, this is F. So, here the value is 2707.2. But, he has given enthalpy at 10 bar is 2700. So, it will be here. Okay. So, this will be here. So, this is the X value. This is F value. So, what he has given? So, HX is given. That is, wet steam enthalpy is given. Because this is less than this one. This is less than this value. That is why I assume that the condition of the steam is wet. So, as I said earlier, HX is equal to HF plus X HFG, right? So, this is nothing but HG minus HF. Okay. So, you can use either of these. So, I have used the same thing. So, from this equation, so I got this value HF, I got this value HG, and you simply do that and the remaining calculator operations are done here. So, this quality is also 0.962. So, you verify this value. So, you don't stop this just by watching this video, and you have to practice on your own, putting steam tables and all these things. And sometimes, if they don't allow the steam tables, they will give you the values, giving some 3-4 pressures. Okay. So, this is about 10 bar. Next problem is this one. I have used a table to explain this one. So, find the mass of 2 meter cube. 2 meter cube is the, meter cube is the unit of volume. So, he has given volume, capital, total volume, 2 meter cube, and at 20 bar and 250 degrees Celsius. So, first it is your duty to find the saturation temperature for this 20 bar. Always, whether he has given or not given, it is better practice to observe from the steam tables what is the saturation temperature. So, knowing the saturation temperature, you can judge whether it is in superheated state, simply dry state, or wet state, all these things. So here I have used the different table, but he has given kilopascals. Understand, it is 20 bar. So kilopascal into 1000, that is 2000. This may be the 20 bar. Got my point? So you must able to convert if not given, or if given another type of units. Okay, from this, what is the HF? This is HF, this is HG, and he has given HFG also. Some books will be provided like this. And what is the specific volume? At this point, you can also do that. But, sorry, not these values, upper values. Okay, so I will erase all these things. So, at 2000, understand. So, HF is equal to 980.29 and this is 279703. But saturation temperature, I have to get this saturation temperature. So, this 212. So, this is temperature at G also. Because temperature at F and G are same. So, but the steam condition is 250 degrees Celsius. So, it is more than the saturation temperature. This is more than 212.37. So, the state of the steam is superheated. So, then we have to neglect this. So, we have to use the superheated steam tables. Okay. So, it is 20 bar. Got my point? For 20 bar, that means it is 2 MPa. 1 MPa is equal to 10 bar. So, 2 MPa is equal to 20 bar. You got my point? So, the temperature is at 250 degree Celsius and the value of specific volume is this. So, that I have taken. You got my point? So, this is the value I have to take and this I have used this formula. How I have to this, what is this? It is capital V. And what is this? It is small v. Okay. So, this is M. What is small v? It is specific volume. Specific volume is equal to volume by mass. So, you will get this one. So, this is given 2 meter cube. And this I got from superheated steam tables. I got this one. So, the mass of the steam is 17.937. Like that, you can also find out whatever. So, find the enthalpy, find the all these things. So, you might have observed here only one value will be given at 250 degree centigrade, at 200 degree centigrade. Now, I will move on to the fourth problem. What is how much heat is needed to convert 1 kg? So, mass is given 1 kg, mass is equal to 1 kg of feed water at 20 degrees Celsius into dry saturated steam at 10 bar. So, he has given the water is supplied at 20, but the steam table will give you 0 degrees. So, that caution must be taken while solving these type of problems. From steam tables, 10 bar at 10 bar, that is HF is equal to 762 and HG is equal to 2000, that is 2777.2 and that is water is from steam tables means you have to assume that water is supplied at 20 0 degrees. But in this case, it is given as 20 degrees. So, from this, what is the heat required? You got my point? So, HG means dry saturated. It is dry saturated. So, dry saturated HG is 277.2. This is HG. Okay. So, if water is supplied at 0 degree centigrade, this is the enthalpy or heat required to make the water into steam at 10 pressure, 10 bar pressure. Okay. So, because it has given at 20 degree Celsius, I have to subtract this amount. So, finally, I got this one. So, that means this much of amount has been saved because the environmental temperature is maybe 20 degree centigrade. So, what is the next problem? And find the external work done during the evaporation at 20 bar and quality 0.85. So, the external work done will be the direct formula. So, you can use this one because PV is the flow work. So, it is the flow of the steam and you can multiply with the quality that straight away you can get this value. Okay. So, at 20 bar, the quality is this one. What is the specific, that is volume of the, that is called specific volume. How do you differentiate volume from specific volume? Volume is, total volume is meter cube, but if it is a specific volume, it is per kg, that is meter cube per kg. Okay, so this is the simple formula that needs to. Next one is, what is that? 2 kg of superheated steam. So he has given, that is superheated, is cooled, that is a steam of 2 bar and so this is quality 2 bar and quality that is 0.9. Okay, so mass of the steam here wrongly printed is 2 kg. So this is 2 kg and this has been given, that is 1 MPa, that means 10 bar. So this is 10 bar. Okay, so it is superheated. So how do you differentiate to superheated? Superheated values are only single values. There won't be any F and FG or G values. So at 300 degree centigrade, so what is H value? So this is 3051.15. This is H superheated. And V superheated, that is 0.2581. You got my point? So what is H2? That means it is the pressure has been reduced. Means suppose it is that is 10 bar and this is suppose 2 bar. You got my point? So this is 2 bar and this is 10 bar. Okay. So this has been reduced. If it is stopped at G, so it has been that is reached the dry saturated. Okay. So it is wet. So that is why he has given quality as 0.9. Okay, so this is 2. H2 means what is this value? HX as per our notation. So HX is equal to, he has given HX are to be obtained. So it is to be obtained. So HF2 is equal to, HF2 means at this condition, that is 2 bar. You got my point? From 10 bar 300 degrees, I got these values. So, from this 2 bar, I have to get the other, that is steam tables. So, 2 bar means this is KPK. Okay. So, 2 bar, what is the HF? This is 504 and HG is 2706. Okay. I have used the same values. See this one. So this is H2, also can also be called as HX. Okay. So, but he is asking internal energy. From the first law of thermodynamics, H is equal to U plus PV. Okay. Next, U is equal to H minus PV. Got my part? H minus PV. So, that has to be known to you. So he is asking a wet condition. So this I can call it as a wet. So since it is wet, I have to multiply this. So this is the formula. So wet is equal to x PV. All these things I have to obtain this one. So I got this value. You have to subtract simply. So I have not done this one, and that is left to you. Okay, can you do that? So I hope you will carry out this one. So why I have drawn this graph? So you have to understand what is the process going on, how it is going on, so that you will not get confused while solving the problems. And it is also wise to draw the figure for it. Thank you for watching this video. So don't forget to leave comments. If not subscribed, please subscribe.